now. It's all yours, Ian.
Yes, good evening, Harry. There's a training exercise, in fact, taking place right now here at Selby Fire Station for some of the on-call firefighters, what used to be known as retained firefighters, people who perhaps have other jobs but work for the fire service as well in their spare time. Bob Hoskins from the fire service. This doesn't sound good, Bob, that one of these fire engines here in Selby and in other places like Skipton and Tadcaster are not on the road sometimes because you haven't got enough firefighters. How can that be safe?
It's absolutely safe. We do have capacity across the brigade to supply fire service to all areas. However, it would be good that all the fire engines we have are manned all the time. So for that, we're on a recruitment drive to raise the profile of on-call firefighters and gain people from the public to support us and to achieve that goal.
Should the public be worried about this, though? You know, having one of these vehicles off the road can't be good.
The public shouldn't worry. Our control work very hard all the time to make appliances available and move cover around the county where it is needed. But again, we do want the resilience to have the on-call staff available as much as possible, and we are struggling during the day.
So these are people who have perhaps other jobs. We can see some pictures, I think, of what happens. A buzzer goes off and then they get to the fire station as quickly as possible and then they go out as firefighters.
That's right. They've got a primary employment, or when they're off work, they have a pager, and when there's an incident, they get paged in. They turn out to the fire station, then get on the fire engine and attend incidents. They are fully qualified firefighters. They go through a very rigorous training and programme to ensure they have all the skills, which then can be used for many purposes back in their own primary employment.
We know a lot of employers are reluctant to release people to do this now, aren't they?
There is. Everyone's had cutbacks and people are running on a lot less staff than they used to. But we are really trying to engage with employers to show how the skills we can give staff obviously can then be used back in the primary employment. So we really want employers to engage with and see how we can work together.
Okay, well, let's quickly talk to some on-call firefighters. Carl, what do you do for a living?
I'm a postman in York, which obviously frees me up to be an on-call firefighter whilst I'm not at work.
And you get a lot out of it?
Yeah, oh, I love it. Yeah, I've made friends for life and skills which I'll always have, yeah.
And of course, we think of big, burly firemen, but here we are. We have Maisie. You're an on-call firefighter as well. Why did you want to do it?
Yeah, it's something that I've always wanted to do, and I wasn't actually aware that you could do it on call. I thought you had to be whole time to do it, but actually I can work for my family business and continue to learn, and yeah, it's amazing, brilliant.
Yeah, so yeah. You're in charge because you have a family business, and Joe, you're a full-time firefighter, but you do this as well in your spare time.
Yeah, that's correct. So for the 4 days I'm at Selby Fire Station, I'm on call, I'm a whole-time firefighter, and then on my days off I'm an on-call firefighter, so that keeps the availability for the second appliance on the run.
You can't get enough, can you? Thank you very much to all of you. Thank you. And very quickly, finally, before we go, just what can people do if they're interested in joining up?
So if people want to come, they can come down to the fire station, talk to the crews and have a little bit of a taster. But also, if they want to join, go to oncallfire.uk and put in your application form, and we'll be in touch as soon as we can.
Okay, thanks very much to all of you. So the training exercise continues here in Selby this evening. And, well, these people really are making a difference, making the community safe.
Ian, thank you very much.